This week on the Aggie Spotlight, I've got Jacob House. Right now he's playing for the Brazos Valley Bombers, but a lot of you know him from playing infield for the Texas A&M baseball team that just made a run at Omaha. I'd like to welcome to the show Jacob House. How are you doing, Jacob?
How's it going?
I guess we'll start off with talking about where you're from, Mansfield. Is that near Is that near Dallas?
It is. It is actually, we are probably 15 minutes south of Arlington. So I always tell people if I get on my roof, I can see the new Cowboys Stadium. But now I guess that's not really as big a deal in Dallas. You can be pretty much anywhere in the Metroplex and see that. So, but yeah, it's south of Arlington and right in the middle of Dallas and Fort Worth.
So did you grow up going to Rangers games, being a huge fan?
I did. Yeah, I'm a huge Rangers fan. So they're my number one team. So it was obviously it's nice to see them in the World Series and last year and everything. But yeah, I mean, we're really close to Ranger Stadium. So definitely a big Rangers fan.
Did you get to go to any playoff games last year?
I didn't. I was big on watching them on TV. So I was actually down here actually taking classes during the summer and then on into the fall. So, but no, I didn't get to go to any games. I haven't gone to any probably about a year and a half or so. But it's been fun watching them on TV. So I've got some friends and family that have went, and they said it was a great time. So, but I was supporting them, watching them on the tube.
The best part about that is you're in the AC.
Yes, exactly. It's not it gets a little bit cooler in the fall up there, but it's still pretty warm when the playoffs start. So. Yeah, definitely. It's a lot nicer to sit home on your couch, a little more comfortable than, however many hundred feet up in the air when it's 110 degrees outside. So
I'm sure you get plenty of the heat anyway, playing, all the summer league and stuff.
Definitely. Yeah, it gets hot down there on the field at Olsen, and driving to the Bombers games, I go right by Olsen too, and it's the temperature gauge on there and the scoreboard says it's been 106, 110, stuff like that. So it's. I'm definitely getting my fair share of heat.
So growing up, did you always play baseball, like T-ball and everything? Did you have any other sports also?
I was pretty much all baseball, but I definitely did. I was actually a big soccer. I was a baseball and soccer. Mixed in a little bit of basketball. Just I took advantage of being tall when I was younger. But, it was mainly baseball and soccer all the way up until high school until I really decided to just play baseball. But, so it's been fun to watch last summer, and then obviously just recently the World Cup has been on, so that's been a pretty cool thing to watch. But, yeah, mainly two sports growing up, but then once I got to high school, I really focused on baseball and knew that I wanted to play, in college and hopefully beyond that, so I just chose to kind of focus on baseball.
By the time they'll be listening to this, I think they'll know the outcome of the World Series, but today's game was pretty exciting, I would say.
It was. Yeah, it was. It was nice. Today's game was awesome, and of course, everyone—I'm sure by now, a lot of people have seen, the game against Brazil, which was great. So, I was definitely yelling and screaming at the television throughout the whole one of that, and then I was pumped today. Watched every minute of the game today as well. So, it's been pretty exciting.
Do you have a favorite player on the team?
Not really. I think that Hope Solo brings a lot of intensity, and she's a good player. So I think it's all, with soccer, there's not a lot of high-scoring games. So I think, defense is definitely key. And obviously Abby Wambach is a stud. She's got the two big goals in the last couple of games, but she's a great player too. But I don't know. I've been pretty impressed by the way that team has played together. They've just got a lot of team spirit, and they really just stick together. Even when they were playing down a man in the Brazil game, it was really impressive. You could just tell, they had a lot of heart.
Definitely. I'm personally a big fan of Alex Morgan, but Abby Wambach and Hope Solo, I definitely agree, are leading the way. You talk about defense. What position did you play whenever you played in high school?
I was actually I played defense when I did play soccer. I did play defense, mixed in a little bit of goalie every once in a while, but I was mainly a defender. So it was always fun to make a big defensive stop or a slide tackle down on our end to really turn the momentum or something like that. But that's been a while ago, so a lot of glory days come up when I think about that. But it's one of those sports that I think takes a true, you know, pretty good athlete to really go out there and compete, and just the endurance, and then the sprinting, and then just being able to, you know, handle your body and the footwork and the control, and then, you know, as much of a team sport as it is, you know, it's such a spotlight sport because, you know, everywhere the ball goes, everyone's looking at you. So I think it's definitely got a good combination of spotlight and team involved in it. So it's really exciting, and obviously I think it's probably the most popular sport around the world. So definitely something that everyone keeps into.
It's definitely a very athletic sport. Do you think that's helped you, that training from soccer helped you as a baseball player with your speed and endurance?
You know, it's kind of funny. I'm not the fastest. I'm not the fleetest of foot on our team by any means. But, you know, I think for one thing, it definitely helped me with like footwork and playing at first base and, you know, being able to move around and being, you know, I kind of take pride in being a little slightly more athletic first baseman. I'm not just a, you know, big tub of lard just hanging out at first base thinking about my next at bat or anything like that. So, yeah, I mean, I definitely take a little from soccer with the footwork and stuff, working around the bag and everything like that. But you know, I think just, you know, when as kids grow up, it's always good for them to play as much as they can, just because it gives you a, you know, such a wide variety, and it really helps you understand, you know, more about athletics and just the concept of team and competing and stuff like that. So I think that's obviously a huge thing too.
Okay. Yeah. Shifting gears a little bit. So you're majoring in communications. Are you hoping to maybe get into radio or TV or anything like that when you graduate or when you get done with your, hopefully, professional career?
Yeah, I mean, hopefully. I mean, like you said, hopefully I can get an opportunity to play after my senior year. If not, then I am completely and totally ready to go out in the real world and get a job. And I love sports. And, you know, recently I've been thinking about radio and journalism and things like that with sports writing. But, you know, one thing that's kind of piqued my interest lately and something that's really important to me is my faith and the Sharing the Victory magazine that we get at our FCA meetings and stuff like that has been really impressive to me. So I've looked into that and just kind of, you know, an opportunity there. But, yeah, definitely. I mean, I would like to, you know, stay with something with sports and, you know, maybe hint on some journalism or maybe even radio. You never know.
So how would you sum up your first year here at A&M?
Overall, I thought it was a great year. You know, it's always nice to end our season in Omaha. I think, you know, I think once you get there, you know, you kind of understand that, all right, this is what we've been working for all season. And it's tough. You know, we lost both games in the World Series, and, you know, we really had a chance to steal one from South Carolina in the first game and came up a little bit short. But, you know, there's seven other teams that went to Omaha that are pretty disappointed too. So, you know, it was tough, but I think that we've got a really good shot. We've got a lot of guys coming back, a good core of the lineup, and then right now, for sure, our top two pitchers are Michael Wacha and Ross Stripling are coming back. So, you know, I think we've got a good chance to go back. I think that we've got a good team, and we're headed by a great guy and a great coach in Rob Childress that does a phenomenal job. He's actually working camp right now, hopefully maybe getting some future Aggies and, you know, 2020, I don't know, the little guys out there. But, yeah. You know, I think we're poised to have a good season this next year too. So I'm excited for it. And once we get everybody back from summer ball here at the end of July, beginning of August, we'll start getting after it with workouts and practice starting in the middle of August when school starts. So, you know, we're ready to get after it and make another run to Omaha.
That's awesome. Well, thank you for the time. And, you know, hey, maybe I don't know what the logistics are about it, but maybe you could be like our baseball correspondent or something next baseball season. Get some radio experience.
Yeah, for sure. That'd be great. So I appreciate it.
All right, thanks.
That's this week's edition of the Aggie Spotlight. Tune in next week as another Brazos Valley Bomber / Aggie baseball player will join us. We'll hear from Adam Smith.